Hi Groovers, Chris here from MTBtips.com. Here's how to determine correct saddle height for maximum pedaling efficiency on a cross-country mountain bike with clipless pedals. Keep in mind, the following steps should be used in conjunction with setting your foot position and your saddle fore aft position. Click the link to find out more about that. Now, notice I said maximum pedaling efficiency. That doesn't always guarantee maximum confidence, fun, and skill on the trails. Sure, pedaling efficiency might be very important for your typical cross-country race, but there are plenty of local trails, even before my dropper post days, where I drop the seat an inch, 3 or even 4 inches, so that I can have a lot more fun and rip the trails even more. Get a dropper post, and you've got the best of both worlds. Position your saddle level with your fork and shock at the correct sag settings for you. Grab a friend to be your eyes for steps 3 to 5. Sit on the saddle, feet on pedals with your riding shoes on. Rotate one crank down so that a straight line can be drawn from the center of the pedal axle through the center of the bottom bracket to the center or virtual center of the top of the seat post. Holding that position and keeping your hips level, extend your legs straight, locking your knee. To find your ideal saddle height, adjust the seat post up or down until the sole of your foot, not the sole of your shoe, is parallel to the ground when you repeat step 4. Then perform steps 1 to 5 with the other foot to find any nuances between left and right.